I was in a police box from the 1960s that fell through the time vortex and landed in the hospital car park outside.
He's got a pulse, but it's very faint. We need to get him out right now.
This is John Smith. He was pulled out of a police box outside the ED, but we don't know if he was like this before or after impact. The doctor's dead.
Doctor?
Holby City doesn't exist. The TARDIS is dying. If I could grab a defibrillator, we could essentially shock the TARDIS.
Got it.
I was making a cup of tea.
Good. Mine's milk, 9 sugars.
I suppose I'll get you some cake to go with it?
Yes. And a punch in the face too, probably.
That was next on the list. So, where are we off to today?
No idea. I tell you what, I'll set the randomizer. You'll search for all previous locations the TARDIS has landed at before and pick one at random.
Sounds good. Just as long as it's not the planet with all the bugs again. That was just... Oof. Another day. Give me your worst.
Come on, what are you doing?
What's the matter?
Oh, come on, what's the matter with you?
Am I invisible? Are you not seeing me?
Sorry, it's just the TARDIS has found a location, but it's saying it can't land.
Do you know what the location is?
No, just these numbers.
Have you tried landing manually?
Sorry, what was that? I blocked you out for a moment.
I'm going to ignore that last bit. I said, have you tried a manual landing?
Why do I block you out? You're quite good, really, aren't you?
There you go. You've redeemed yourself from that last comment. What would you do without me, eh?
Probably a lot of damage.
Doctor, is there something wrong with the scanner?
No, not that I know of. It was working fine a minute ago. You saw it. Why? What's it doing?
I don't know, it's just not showing where we are.
I don't think we're anywhere that exists. The void, maybe?
Or a motorway?
What? Huh. So it is.
Come on then, let's go find out why it didn't register on the scanner.
No, hang on a minute. Let me grab my glasses. No screwdriver anymore. Thanks to someone dropping it in the bath.
It's not my fault. You shouldn't leave your tech stuff near water. Didn't your mother ever teach you that? Anyway, why do I have to wait for you? Worried you're getting a bit slow in your old age?
Never mind Daleks, Ice Warriors, and Zontarans. It's these motorways you need to worry about. Death traps.
I don't need my hand held crossing the road, Doctor.
No, I'm sure you don't, Clara. But just to be on the safe side. Clara! Is there a particular reason you're standing here, Dylan?
Yes, actually. I was waiting for you.
Is my office not to your comfort?
No, I just thought it'd be easier if... You know what? It doesn't matter.
So, what was it you wanted to see me for, Dylan? I'm very busy today.
Well, I've been looking through and sorting old records, and some of them don't add up. Two in particular, actually.
Right. Have you run this past the relevant people?
Yes.
And?
They can't work it out either.
So, who are these patients? Are they connected in any way?
Well, they were brought in at the same time. One treated and discharged, the other deceased.
Right. Sorry, Dylan. Where's the problem here?
I checked with the morgue. His body went missing an hour or so after he was put there.
Right. And the other one was discharged. What's the issue with her?
Well, it could just be an error, but she's not registered with any hospital or GP. I've done checks. Oh, and there was something else about the guy. On his x-ray, it seemed that there was a binary vascular system.
Two hearts?
Mm-hmm.
Sorry, what did you say these patients were called?
I didn't.
Okay, well what were their names?
The man was Dr. John Smith, and the woman, Miss Clara Oswald. It's down as you treating the man, and Charlie and Ethan as treating the woman. Do you remember?
Oh God, yes. It's all coming back now. I remember. He was the victim from that crash outside the hospital. There was nothing more we could do for him. It was like his body had just shut down. Nothing was working, and his system seemed infinitely complex.
And the girl?
Yes. I had to tell her he was dead. We started talking about that x-ray, I'm sure of it. We were talking, and then one of the nurses called me away. That was when he went into VF and I had to make the call. But I don't know what happened to her after that. I assume Ethan discharged her.
He did. Charlie wanted her to see someone because she kept talking about time travel and flying police boxes. But she never went down to the appointment that was arranged.
It's okay, Dylan. Thank you for bringing this to my attention. I'll take care of it.
Okay, I'll leave then.
It's going to be all right. What were you thinking? I told you to wait. Maybe I do need my hand holding after all. It's okay. The ambulance is coming.
What's happened here?
This is Clara. I'm the doctor. She was hit by a pudding train traveling, given her injuries about 20 miles over the speed limit.
A doctor, eh? What sort?
Nothing you'd understand.
You okay? You're gonna be alright now.
This is, looking bad.
Holby ED, recess.
We've got a major RTC, southbound on the motorway.
Okay. Have you assessed the victims?
She's in a bad way. Query fractured radius as well as tib and fib. Also, possible internal injury, but we can't really assess it well enough out here. GCS-10, SATs 94%.
All received. We'll be ready. There's been an RTC on the motorway. We're receiving...
What? I'm on a break. Can't you get Ethan or Cal to assist you?
Both with patients.
Fine. Page me when you have an ETA.
That's more like it.
What's the breacher?
Okay, we'll have recess ready. Do we have a name so we can dig out some old notes? What? No, sorry. Say that again? That's what I thought you said. Okay, we'll see you in a minute.
Connie, is there a problem?
I think we're about to find out what happened to our mystery patients. The patient involved in the RTC is called Clara Oswald.
You don't think it's really her, do you? I mean, how many people must there be with that name? It's a shot in the dark.
Well, let's go and see.
It's alright, Clara. I'm not losing you today.
Doctor, in case I don't make it,
No, don't say that. You're going to be just fine. Doctor, if I don't stop saying that, Clara, you're not going anywhere. Doctor, please, just listen. If I don't make it, I need to know. Know what? I need to know. How did I do? Oh, Clara, you are phenomenal. Always had my back since day one. Sideman in the TARDIS, remember? Yeah. Good, focus on those memories, those amazing memories of the madman with a box that turned into a grumpy Scot. Still equal to you, though. Think of that, because I am going to make sure that you do not die today.
Okay, ma'am, we're gonna have to put your foot down. We're losing her. Right, this is Clara, 30 years old, hit by ongoing traffic at what this fellow here reckons about 85 miles an hour. Gaining access has been difficult due to chronic fractured radius, so getting by her hasn't been really much joy. She also has a chronic fractured temple fear, but some sort of force energies is intense.
Right, Charlie, can we get a line in ASAP, please?
You need to be seen to.
Why? I'm not the one that was hit by a car.
No, but you're definitely in shock. Now come on, let me just give you the once over.
I'm not leaving, my friend.
You leave my way or you'll be escorted out by security.
Okay. You win.
I tend to. Now come on.
Why is it whenever this woman turns up, it's always under unnatural circumstances? I mean, how do you get hit by a car on the motorway? What was she doing there, and who's that bloke she's with this time?
I don't know, but I'm sure Dylan will get something out of him.
Name?
The Doctor.
That isn't a name.
You wouldn't understand. I'm a Time Lord.
Okay, I'll be back in a minute.
Everything okay?
Either that man is delusional, or he's just stupid.
I'm sure you'll manage.
Dylan, what do you want now?
That man she came in with.
Yes? What about him?
Well, he's claiming he's called the Doctor. Simply the Doctor.
This is the same man that came in with my patient, yes?
Yes.
Right, thank you, Dylan. When I'm done here, I'll be through to talk to him.
Oh, Clara.
Doctor, whatever your name is, you can't go in there.
Dylan, can you control your patient, please?
Come on, let's get you back to your cubicle.
I'm not going anywhere. Not now. Now, what's happening? Tell me.
Okay, she's arrested. Let's shock her. Okay, charging. All clear. Shocking.
Oh, I'm fine. Don't worry about me. What's happening with Clara?
I think we have to face facts here. I think it's time. She's been down for 45 minutes.
No.
I'm terribly sorry. Are we all in agreement?
No, we are not all in agreement.
I'm sorry. I really am. Time of death, 1437. Thank you, everyone.
No, Clara, please, just come back. Please.
Thank you. initiate the final phase, planet Earth will bow down to the new masters of Earth. Daleks conquer and destroy. Daleks conquer and destroy. Daleks conquer and destroy.
Please, there has to be something you can do. I'm sorry. I truly am. But I'm afraid her injuries were too severe. She's gone. I'm very sorry for your loss.
The plan is in place. Soon the doctor will be procured. Excellent. The experiment will commence.
Give them the satisfaction of abduction. I'll make my own way, thanks.
Where's the man that was with her? I need to talk to him.
He left a while ago.
Hello. Long time no see. So, what have you been up to then? Rebuilding yourselves by the looks of things. Nice. Varied, I'll give you that. Bit of old, bit of new. I like it.
Where is your associate?
More to the point, why did you abduct me?
You are the doctor. You do not travel alone.
Alright, if you're gonna keep rubbing salt in the wound, she's dead. So no. I don't tend to travel alone, but as of 45 minutes ago, I do. Now answer my question.
You are required.
Required? For what? If I were you, I'd choose your words very carefully, because I've just lost someone very, very dear to me. So right now, I am so close to the edge.
You are required for the experiment.
Experiment? What does that mean?
Hello, Doctor.
I'm sorry, do I know you?
Better than you might think. I said we'd meet again soon. Here I am.
No.
We will meet again, Doctor. Soon.
You can't be.
Did we do everything we could? Could I have done any more?
You did everything you could. Nobody could have asked any more of you. Get somebody sent up to the morgue and get cleaned up.
Thanks. Can you make sure we try and track down that man, please? Tell him we need someone to collect Clara's things.
Doctor, you will enter the chamber.
Why?
You will become part of the experiment. The Dalek Time Lord hybrid will present itself.
No, you can't, Master. You can't seriously be thinking about letting them do this.
Oh, I'm sorry, you're talking to me. I'm not the master anymore. I'm the mistress. Missy for short.
Okay, whatever you call yourself, you can't let them do it. You know what'll happen. The consequences will cause fractures throughout the whole of time and space. Every event will rupture. Nothing and nobody will be safe.
I know. Isn't it exciting?
Proceed.
You finally got round to reading their files, then?
Yes. Is there something I can help you with?
Oh, I've got the post-mortem results of Clara Oswald.
Put them on my desk, please.
Are you alright?
Sorry, why do people keep checking in on me?
Oh, sorry, Connie.
Just tell anyone not to interrupt me for a while.
Did the experiment succeed? I do not understand. Scan indicates non-compatible Time Lord DNA.
What? No, that's not possible. It's the Doctor. How can he not be compatible?
He cannot be compatible because he's not the Doctor. What do you mean? Explain. Explain.
Alright, keep your dome on. He's not me because... he's a hologram. You think I just step out and let you take me? Of course not. So I created a hologram me, close enough to the real thing, a little bit rough around the edges, colouring was off, but all done via the sonic glasses. Now then, I'm going to give you one chance. One chance, that's all you're getting. Leave. Or I'll make you.
No. Initiate.
Initiate? Initiate what?
Their next plan, Doctor. The experiment failed, so now they'll continue conquering until they don't. And they'll start by turning everyone on that planet into Daleks, starting with Holby below.
And how do you plan to do that? Hey, Power Ranger, I'm talking to you. How can you turn an entire city's population of people into Daleks if they don't exist?
I do not understand, Doctor.
Well, it's not real. Holby's not a real city. It doesn't exist. Come on, just admit it. You created it to lure me in.
The city's origin is not the work of us.
But it's... well, it's not. Well, it's pretty impressive, I'll give you that. What would be the point in creating a whole city? More than that, a fictional one. How did we get here before? That's it. I created this place. The universe needed rebooting, I was the man for the job. In turn, it created this place. But I still have one question. Why Holby? Of all the cities to create, why this one? Why? Oh God, here we go. I need to warn them. There's an invasion coming, you have to get out.
You were with Clara, weren't you?
Oh sorry, who are you?
Mrs. Beecham. I treated your friend.
Oh yes, so you did. Sorry, I deleted you.
There's something I need to talk to you about.
Look, I'd love to, but we need to start evacuating. There's an attack coming, bigger than anything this city will have seen before.
Well then, why are we standing here talking?
Fleet strength at 94%. Full capacity will be reached in 100 rels. Excellent. The invasion begins.
And what about me?
You are no longer required. You have fulfilled your purpose, and now you will be exterminated. Exterminate, exterminate, exterminate.
Oh, honey.
Hello again. No time to talk.
Oh, and who's this?
This is Connie, not a Clara replacement. She's just helping out. Probably best not to talk to her for a minute. She's adjusting to the TARDIS.
Okay. How do we stop the Daleks?
Oh, you've changed your tune. One minute it's destruction of time and space, and the next is how do we stop them?
Well, you know me.
Yes, I do. That's what worries me.
So, what's happening?
Ah, you're back with us, Beecham. What was it you wanted to talk to me about?
I have no idea.
Ah, humans. Such funny little brains. I don't know how you remember to tie your shoelaces, really. Humans. As in, I am not one, and neither is she.
Right. Oh, that's what I needed to talk to you about.
Yes, well, we can all sit down and have tea and cake later. But right now, I feel like there's a Dalek fleet landing on your doorstep, dear.
Da-what? Daleks. Most ruthless killing machines in all of history. A mutant locked inside a tank that'll kill anything that isn't like it.
Well, how do we stop them? I've got patients and staff down there in that hospital.
Yes. Well, this is what we need to work out. Master.
Missy. My name is Missy.
Okay, whatever. When I saw you last, you were sabotaging my past selves, yes?
Yes, so?
So everything. Changing time in any manner of way creates time energy. If you're messing around with my timeline, then you're bound to get some feedback. And a lot of that rejected energy was probably absorbed by the TARDIS when we were on Trenzalore.
Okay. So where are you going with this, Doctor?
So that's how we stop the Daleks. They want a hybrid. We're gonna give them a hybrid.
Charlie, you okay?
I'm fine. Keep getting them out of here.
You will be exterminated. Exterminate, exterminate, exterminate.
So you're just going to wipe them out?
Yep, pretty much. They wanted their Dalek Time Lord hybrid, and that's exactly what I'm going to give them. This time, they're getting more than they bargained for.
So we're going to overload their systems and flood the place with time energy, which will be too much for them. Right here, there's thousands of times more energy than the Daleks would have gone through the experiment they planned.
Right then, time to put this plan of action into... well, action. That could have been worded better.
Oh, just land, will you? Watching you try to speak is just painful.
How didn't it kill us?
Shot. Maybe it missed.
They don't seem the sort of things that would take a shot and miss.
Maybe they don't know why either. Maybe that's why they left us.
I don't care why. I'm just happy we're alive. Come on, we need to get out of here.
TARDIS materializing.
Right, Connie, you stay here. When I tell you to, I need you to press this button right here, okay? Missy, you're coming out there with me.
Good. I'd get so bored in here. Might have ended up killing her.
Right, come on. It's showtime. Hello again. Honestly, we can't keep meeting like this.
Why are you here, Doctor?
Well, do you remember earlier when you tried to get me to become part of that Dalek Time Lord hybrid thingy? Well, I've had a chance to think about it, and you know what? I'm up for it.
Explain yourself.
I am fine with you doing this, but I do have two conditions. Number one, you leave Holby, and you don't come back. Number two, we do it my way.
We accept these conditions.
Right, good. Now withdraw the Daleks that are already down there.
All units, withdraw. Daleks withdrawn. Now, Doctor, how do we proceed?
Well, you want the regeneration energy of a Time Lord? Basically make you, well, immortal, indestructible, untouchable?
So here's all the regeneration energy that you could ever want, and more.
Now, Beecham!
My vision is impaired.
Oh, well, isn't that a pity?
I cannot see. Doctor, what have you done?
Exactly what you wanted. Well, I say exactly. What I mean is more. More energy than you can possibly cope with. I've given you so much energy that your systems cannot cope. I've given you energy from every single one of my incarnations. Don't ever think you can play me for a fool, Daleks. Because I will always come back. And when I do, I'm stronger than ever. And never think you can outsmart me, because I will always be one step ahead of you. You
are the creatures who endanger the people, and I am the one who rescues them. Because that's what I do, day in, day out. I am the Doctor, and I save people. So come on, show me what you've got now, eh? Oh, wait. That's nothing. Nothing at all. Because, once again, oh, sorry, the Doctor's got you. This planet is protected by me. So bear that in mind. Give it a second's thought the next time you think of invading. Think of the Doctor. And then... run! Time to go. Get in, Missy.
Well, that's something I won't be forgetting in a hurry. Well, I'm not sure, really. You might all forget it ever happened. Humans, you'd probably blame it on a dodgy sandwich or something.
Or the weather. Or global warming. Oh, they love blaming things on global warming.
Oh, that's classic. In all seriousness, though, Doctor, are we going to forget?
Yes. Because I'm going to make you.
What?
I'm going to make you forget everything that happened to you after meeting me today.
Why?
Because it's better that way. I mean, look what happened to Clara. I took her with me for so long, and now she's dead. Nobody else. No more. I need to see Clara.
Come with me. I'll take you to her.
I'll wait here then, I suppose.
Oh, Clara. My Clara. I'm so sorry. Nobody else. Not on my watch.
Doctor? Are you alright?
Yeah, I'm fine. I wiped Connie's memory. She'll forget all about me, and the Daleks, and everything that happened today. The only thing she will remember is... Clara. Still, it's better that way. Onwards and upwards. Time to grow up. Stop putting people in the firing line.
Doctor, you need to accept this. It wasn't your fault. Just remember that, okay?
So, where to next?
Did you get a chance to take a look at Clara's postmortem results? I know it's been a bit hectic here today.
Has it? Have I missed something?
Are you telling me you didn't see or hear the massive spaceship in the sky? Or the robot things that invaded the hospital?
Someone put something in your coffee, Dylan.
I wish. Okay. Well, did you track down that man that Clara Oswald came in with?
What man's that, then?
Oh, I don't know. He called himself the Doctor, didn't he?
The Doctor? Doctor who?
Hold on. He looks familiar.
Oh, it's him. 30 years. Wow. He really needs to get out more.
Hey, watch what you're doing.
Oh, I'm terribly sorry, Connie.
How do you know my...
Tell Charlie congratulations for me, won't you?
Sorry, what?
30 years. It's quite an achievement.
How do you know all this? Who are you?
A friend. Just passing through. Oh, and if I were you, I'd drive carefully.
What's that supposed to mean?
Just remember, keep your friends close, but your enemies closer. You never know what might happen.